Maydestone was built in 1910, and a lot of historians, they have really passion for this building and they wanted to save it. When I started working with the SMUD, it was a very pleasant experience, I mean, from beginning to the end, and they helped me go through the building and see what kind of efficiency we need to make that saving by design. When I started with Mike and Gary, we went through all the efficiency measures that what we can do to make it more efficient.
We did some energy modeling early on in the project that helped us guide decisions on what would be the best system choices, and so this was a perfect candidate for savings by design.
I think the tenants who are going to live in the building are getting an incredible deal. I mean, it's a beautiful building.
One of the vision I had when I started the Maydestone to make sure that the history be in the building. Our goal was to keep the any significant character of the building remain the same. Like behind me, the trundle bed. It's a pull-up bed, all the unit has it, which is really cool feature, everybody loves it. In the basement, we try to be something different, and more industrial, because the basement didn't have any character, it was just a storage. We did more artistic, tried to bring local artists into the building and try to show their pieces.
Well, this building is 100 years old. It needed a major renovation of all the systems, the mechanical system, the lighting system, and the building envelope.
There was no insulation in the building whatsoever that I can recall. Certainly nothing in the walls. We filled the attic cavity with blown-in fiberglass insulation to R49. So they really filled it all up. And then on top of that, we put one of the cool roofs. And the cool roof is really great because it reflects heat off the roof and keeps the whole building cooler.
The air conditioning system is very efficient. It's approximately 50% more efficient than the standard design. They feature a ductless system. They provide just the amount of cooling that is required by the occupant for the space. They're very less intrusive compared to a traditional system. So for an historic building like the Maydestone, they're a perfect fit.
One of the things that we had to work around was the windows. The historical character of the building dictated that you couldn't do much with the windows. So the things that we came up with were the awnings. That's what people used to do to cut heat gain into their homes and businesses, is they would put up an awning. With a very attractive red awning that fit really well with the building scheme. And they put it on the most important places, which was on the south and the west window, because that's where you get most of your heat gain. In addition, we also discovered a window films. The window films have really advanced lately. We put the window film on all the east, south, and west windows. Particularly those east windows will make a huge impact, because the window films cut about 50% of the heat gain.
Solar hot water is a significant part of the energy pie for multifamily, and adding solar hot water heating will reduce their energy hot water needs by 50%.
That saves a lot of money. It works best on the hottest days of the year and reduces the peak demand.
The photovoltaic system was something that didn't come up in initial design because we thought, well, we were putting a solar hot water system up there and there was limited roof space, and then he had to put all his air conditioning condensing units up there as well. We didn't think he'd have enough room for it. He was able to put up about 13,000 watts worth of PV, solar electric system, and they did an excellent job of sizing it. That system's gonna cover the home load or the house load, which is like for the corridor lighting, the rec room, heating and air conditioning.
The old style cage elevator was historic, but it needed to be replaced. We replaced that elevator with a new energy efficient elevator.
The system installed here is what's called regenerative, thus meaning that power flows both ways. It consumes power when it's doing work and it puts power back when it's overhauling conditions. That regenerates power. This system is 90%+ efficient. So the power consumption is only 8 to 10% of the overall power to operate this elevator.
LEDs have really come a long way. We have this great LED lamp put out by Cree, and what's great about it is it looks just like an incandescent. People can dim it, and it has a 50,000 hour life. And they use about a quarter of the energy that a typical incandescent does.
The most important aspect about our involvement in this project is that we're helping to restore downtown and the vitality of living downtown.
I think it shows that you can combine high performance, high efficiency building with an historic structure. Oftentimes they seem to be in conflict, but in this case, it came together really well.
It was very rewarding when the whole building got done and people looked at it, and all the residents are so excited about it. It was very rewarding, the whole experience.